Taurus, this is Soul. And Taurus, this is your week ahead in terms of messages for July 31st through August 6th, 2017. The messages will also be for Taurus Moon and Taurus Rising. Okay, my bulls, I hope that all is well. Let's get right into your messages. So we're going to start off with the Nine of Wands or Staves. For some of you this upcoming week in terms of energy. So it's in the upright. So, of course, traditionally it means, you know, external and internal battles and struggles. The person on this card, always pay attention to which direction that the characters are facing. There's something going on back here. There could be some sort of battles and struggles going on, or could be with fire signs, since the wands represent Leo, Aries, Sagittarius, male or female, but it could be with any zodiac sign in its energy. But I'm picking up strongly that some of you are dealing with fire sign energies because of the King of Wands in the past position is showing up in the reverse. And this could also represent female energies as well. So the King is looking in the direction of the future. So maybe it's the fire sign energy, if it is something that you're doing battles and having battles and struggles with, they're looking forward to ending those things with you. Okay, it's like they're done, they're tired, or whatever. Wands always represent physical cards of energy and movement for me. So if you're not dealing with external situations, externally meaning other people interfering with Taurus's personal life and stuff, then it could be just you having to have multiple things going on. Also, too, keep in mind, I don't always pick up negative energies with these wands when they show up. Sometimes it could be just for some of you this upcoming week having so much energy to tackle, using the wands as an example of multiple things to do. And to, you know, because they could be multiple things on your plate that you need to take care of. It's just letting me know that you will have the energy to succeed and tackle all of those things that need to be, you know, taken care of. Again, this is a general reading, so apply it to your situation. But I am strongly feeling that the character is looking backwards. This could be representative of your energy and that energy that I spoke of regarding Leo, Aries, or Sagittarius, male or female. Somebody wants to put an end to either possible friction or having to be feeling like they're personally attacked. See, because this person is behind a couple of those staves. And it's almost like, you know, a description of being, you know, barred or in prison. Okay. And they're looking out. Like, okay, I'm ready to end this shit right now. Okay, I'm done. So it could be just the fire sign. With the King showing up, it could also represent female energies. It could be a week where not only do you get the energy that you need to tackle those tasks that you have to complete this week, but because it's showing up in the past position, that's what I'm getting. Could be a completion of energy related to multiple tasks or having too many things on your plate for a few Tauruses that I'm reading for. Okay, so I'm trying to get out the messages the best that I can for you because it's not going to apply for, you know, everyone. But this King showing up here is an actual person. All right. And it's a, you know, it's a court card, so it's an actual person. But I feel that there is something going on with fire signs and earth signs. This could be an older, because I always get an older feel when the Kings and the Queens show up. So this could be a parent. This could be having to do some sort of battles and struggles with a parent, and the parent is ready to you know, end those battles, or they're just just tired of fighting, possibly tired of fighting because it's getting nowhere. This could be, you know, an older friendship. This could be things happening in the family structure. Also could be in the workplace environment. Even though we don't have the pentacles to support that, intuitively I'm picking up this could be something going on in terms of either multitasking or having to do some sort of a lot of physical work and movement in the workplace environment. And the pressure is coming from someone who is higher than you. This is the King, okay? Middle of the week, then we have the Five of Staves, which is the Five of Wands in the reverse. So that's actually pretty good because it's the winding down of possibly the energy that I picked up. If you are doing any battles and struggles with anyone from your past, that energy is winding down. Fives and tens always represents potential things to come. Tens most likely a change, and fives also represent that change, new energy coming your way. Friday going into the weekend, now we have the Seven of Cups in the upright position. So this is something that could be, you know, dealing with some sort of emotional aspects, but I feel that it could be happy emotional aspects or an outcome to a situation. Seven of Cups is all about options, and also too, it's a warning. Sometimes the Seven of Cups shows up as a warning, and having to have multiple options to pick and choose from, make sure that you are focused enough and that you're choosing whatever it is from these cups that's going to resonate for you in the long term. Also, too, the cups represent love and emotion, so that could be something going on with relationships. Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, male or female could be involved in that situation, but it could be anything. Just pay attention to possible multiple options that might come up for you Friday going into the weekend. Okay, so Taurus, this is your reading. Don't forget to look at your moon sign and your rising signs for additional information. And before I go, cups always represent children for me, so there might be something going on connected to Taurus if they have water sign children, but they can have any children, but there might be some sort of emotional stuff going on. Now, I'm not getting that it's, you know, negative emotions. It could be positive emotions. Maybe there's several things going on emotionally with children of Taurus. So that could be a case. The King of Staves or Wands mirrors the Seven of Cups. So I feel that it's an older against the younger. So the parent or the child, or the child and the parent. Okay, there you go, Taurus. I hope this is helpful and beneficial. Again, don't forget to look at your moon sign and your rising signs for additional information. With that being said, I want to wish you all a very safe upcoming week ahead, emphasizing safety as I always do, sending out a lot of love and light to you guys, or you all, until I talk to you again, Taurus. Be well. Bye.